limited. I think we're just like, over the course of, you know, however long we've been making music, just feel confident as to whatever track needed. We don't have any sort of rules. I mean, on this record, we've had like great players come down and play piano or bass guitar with us, but then we've like delved even more deeply into sort of synthesis and you know, that combination. But I just feel like when we're making a record, we're just confident, really. We don't feel like hamstrung by anyone, like any kind of expectations of what instrumentation we're going to use. It's just whatever makes the music that we want to make.
We're musicians, you know, still, it's a fine line. You know, a lot of people get lost in the sort of the world of technology and the sort of the machines they use, and it become, you know, that becomes more important to them than making music. You know, go on the internet and you see people talking about synthesizers, and they're not really interested in making music with these things. They're interested in them from a sort of scientific kind of electronic perspective. And, you know, for us, these are still instruments to try and convey something. You know, as well, for a lot of people, the end of it is just the process of what they're actually doing. You know, it's just important for us to keep the fact that these are things to make music with. All my thoughts are all the same. All insane. Do it again.
We DJed less and less, but we played New Year's Eve, we played a bit of stuff that we're working on that seemed to sound good. Particularly Burst Generator is a really good DJ track. It kind of captures a lot of what we like about records that we play out. It's building intensity and good groove. And
actually, yeah, because we played that on New Year's Eve, and we played it as a sort of record. You know, people usually play a big record at midnight that everyone knows and can get. We decided to play that record that no one had heard before, but it totally worked amazingly. And it was like, you know, people have not heard this music before, but it seemed to just have the right emotion for midnight kind of record. That was a good thing, you know, it worked at that position.
We never really DJed like tons. We had a year where we played every week, and I think that did for us, really. But we like it if it means going away somewhere or just doing something different. But
we DJ every often, don't we? Every so often.
Yeah.
It's good. Keeps your sort of eye in, keeps you aware. You know, when we just made the track Saturate on the album last, we played in Spain and we played it at a massive rave and it sounded brilliant. I mean, you know, that was just sometimes quite good. You know, you make records and then, you know, in your studio you can become a bit divorced from things, and then it's very good to just see it in real life and see how it really relates to people and how you feel as well when you're playing it in front of people, whether it still feels as good as if you imagine. It's quite easy to be really into something on your own in the studio and go, yeah, this is best piece of record, best piece of music I've ever heard. And then you play it in front of someone else, and you're like, well, actually, maybe not. You know, then you play it to like 10,000 people in the hall, and you still feel that it's really good, then it's a good thing. Some songs lend themselves to being played as they are, you know, and they're written that way because that's how they work. But lots of other kind of songs that we do are really work well to be totally rearranged and played with. And, you know, also when we're making a song, there's so many parts of that song that don't make it to the final track, you know. And so there's might be reams and reams of different sounds and whole different sequences and sections and stuff that don't make it onto the album, and it's quite good fun to get those bits and put those into the when we play live. Because it's sort of like the version on the album, you know, is your idea of how it should be, but there's so many different ways it could have gone. You know, when you're making a record, sometimes you're aware that, oh, it's just this sprawling thing and it's going on too long. But when you're playing live, that can be quite attractive to have something that is not strictly arranged and stuff and is just splurging out. It's quite liberating, really. I like that. Oh my God, what have I done? Do it again. All I wanted was a little fun. Do it again. Got a brain like bubblegum. Do it again. Blowing up my cranium. Do it again.